안녕하십니까 꿀팁 시청자 여러분, 꿀닷컴 편집장 알쌤입니다. 한국 시간으로 어제 오후였죠. 조세 무리뉴 감독이 경질당했습니다. 네, 토트넘 핫스퍼는 현지 시간으로 19일 오전에 무리뉴 감독의 경질 사실을 이제 공식적으로 발표를 했고요. 이로써 토트넘과 무리뉴 감독의 17개월의 동행은 끝이 났습니다. 네, 2019년 11월 마우리시오 포체티노 감독의 뒤를 이어 토트넘에 부임한 무리뉴 감독은 2년 차인 올 시즌 초반에 프리미어리그에서 선두로 뛰어오르며 2년차 우승 DNA를 발동시키나 했는데, 중반으로 접어들수록 승리를 따내지 못하는 경기가 많아지면서 32라운드를 치른 현재 리그 7위에 머물고 있습니다. 축구 통계업체 옵타에 따르면 무리뉴 감독은 토트넘 감독으로서 총 86경기 44승 19무 23패 승률을 51.2% 기록을 했고요. 프리미어리그에서만 58경기 27승 14무 17패 174점의 승점 중 95점을 획득하는데 그쳤습니다. 첼시 첫 해나 아니면 2012년 레알 마드리드에서 보여줬던 70% 후반대의 승률을 자랑하던 것에 비하면 많이 아쉬운 성적이면은 틀림없죠. 하지만 이번 주말 맨시티와의 리그컵 결승을 코앞에 두고 감독을 경질했다는 소식은 놀랍기만 한데요. 그래서 저희 꼴닷컴 코리아는 현지의 꼴닷컴 UK 니자르 키니셀라 기자와 무리뉴 감독 경질에 대한 현지 반응과 분위기에 대해 이야기해보았습니다.
Hi guys, this is Nizar Kinsella, Goal.com's reporter in London, talking about Jose Mourinho sacking at Tottenham Hotspur. I wanted to talk about the moment that Jose Mourinho left Tottenham. The moment Jose Mourinho left Tottenham, you know, and lost the trust of Daniel Levy, was pretty much a gradual one in my opinion. You know, okay, we can talk about the Everton match, where they drew 2-2, dropping more points, losing ground in the top four race, which is a really big driver of Tottenham Hotspur. You know, they see finishing in the top four as a really massive part of the club, and they wanted Jose Mourinho also to come in and bridge that gap. You know, Pochettino built Tottenham, and they wanted Mourinho to take them to the next level. You know, win trophies. He's been a winner in the past, but they wanted him to win for them in this present, and it didn't look like he would. Now, we can say strange timing about sacking him before a cup final. But they really believed that, you know, the squad no longer believed in Jose Mourinho, his methods, and his man management as well. And I think that's particularly the point, that they didn't believe in those aspects. And they decided to make the decision to sack him. So I kind of think that those are some of the reasons why Jose Mourinho has been let go from Tottenham, and Ryan Mason, who used to play for the club, is coming in to be a caretaker manager and lead them into the Carabao Cup final this weekend. Another reason that's been cited as being a factor in Jose Mourinho's sacking was the Super League. Now Tottenham Hotspur are going to be one of the 12 founding clubs in a Super League that features the big six from the Premier League, you know, and several European clubs just from Italy and Spain. So that was cited as a reason, but I understand, and this is my information, that that's totally untrue. You know, it was purely a decision based on performance, based on, you know, a lack of results in recent weeks. So don't listen to any rumours that relate to the Super League and Jose Mourinho sacking. And in my opinion, it's actually really far-fetched to think that that might be a reason that Jose Mourinho would leave Tottenham Hotspur. Yeah, the decision to sack Jose Mourinho has been kind of rumoured in the last few weeks. There's been lots of reports from other UK media saying that Jose Mourinho's in danger. There's a little bit, you know, from us as well at Goal saying that Jose Mourinho's in danger. But so it wasn't that unexpected, you know, that he's been sacked. The only unexpected thing is the timing. To do it right before a cup final is a great surprise. So yeah, I think that it's not a surprise that he's been sacked, but it is a surprise that it came before the cup final. He was in danger. He's been in danger for a very long time, but it's just, you know, why not let him lead the club into a cup final? They obviously thought that they have a better chance without Mourinho than they do with him. Yeah, I'm not sure who the next manager of Tottenham will be. The rumours seem to be linking Julian Nagelsmann, Brendan Rodgers, and, you know, Ralf Hasenhüttl as well, I've heard, you know, in the mix. None of it particularly reliable. A lot of it's coming from bookmakers, gambling companies, things like that. We don't know for certain who's going to come in at Tottenham. I think that will become clear in the next few weeks and months, and probably You know, Ryan Mason, who is the caretaker manager, will lead the club until the end of the season. And then I think in the summer, usually you find it easier to bring in a manager. You have the time. And that's when Tottenham, I think, will do the business of bringing in a manager for the full time and to take the club forward to the next level. Yeah, on Son and Kane's future, I'd say they're in doubt. Certainly we know a lot about Kane, you know, as an Englishman, reporting in English football from this country. Kane's been talked about again and again and again because he gave an interview last time he was with England saying that, you know, if Tottenham don't challenge for trophies, if they can't win things, that he has to consider his future. Now, I know that Tottenham aren't going to let Kane go easily, so that's going to be an issue. They're going to ask for a lot of money, and they really don't want Kane to leave because they know what a key player he is. You know, Son Heung-min as well, he's exactly the same. You know, I feel like it's almost an identical situation. This is a world-class player who could also leave, who could also push to leave, you know, should he get offers, and should, you know, clubs come forward. He's similarly world-class. He's similarly been performing, even though Tottenham haven't. And I think there's a market for Son as well. So, yeah, I think that, you know, those players really, you know, could be going in the summer, maybe one or the other. I can't see them both leaving. You know, Tottenham would not allow that. But it would take also a sensational fee, and in the COVID market, it's difficult. But, you know, in those guys' heads, they must be thinking, maybe I can leave Tottenham. Maybe I should think about leaving Tottenham in the near future. So if it's possible, I think they'll explore it. But it will be very, very difficult because Spurs are still a very rich club. They don't need to sell. It's just that their players are getting a bit fed up that they're not competing for trophies.